left Cauteret after our rest day. It's Thursday the 2nd of July. And as you can see, we're on our way up to the Col de Riou. It's another of the acclaimed 1,000 metre climbs. But this morning it's somewhat misty. Yesterday there was a thunderstorm in the afternoon and another one in the middle of last night. So we're hoping we can get over the top before anything else comes in. But as you can see, there's not much of a view this morning. Cauteret was nice in a way, but proved to be a little frustrating in some ways. The laundrette was occupied when we got there.
The restaurant was closed,
yeah, where we thought we might have lunch, that didn't open at all yesterday, despite what he said the night before, about being open every day and all day.
This morning, the place where we were going to get some lovely quiches.
Yeah, that was shut as well. Yeah, we'd recked a boulangerie patisserie and that was shut at all. So we ended up with ham on bread again.
The church was lovely and there was a concert.
Yeah, we missed the concert, we just got the tail end. We had a nice dinner last night, tighty flat again.
So we're glad to see the back of the club.
Well, in a way.
Terrible bed.
Yes, it was. Yeah, the room was nice, the hotel was nice, but the bed wasn't so good.
Lumpy.
It wasn't long enough, it was a bit lumpy and it had a mattress protector on, so we sweated like pigs.
Anyway.
And you couldn't turn over properly.
Forget the boring bit.
Yeah, but now we're off up the hill again.
To supposedly?
It's supposed to be a nice place, the Auberge Le Bruyère. At Grust.
And Grust is supposed to be
a nice village according to our postman. It was a nice village. And we've sorted out our doubts about Oridon as well. So, yeah, off we go. Well, we've reached the Chalet de la Reno tent, or at least the restaurant with its name, about an hour out. Undergoing some renovation, although it looks like it's in business. According to the sign, another 2 hours, 15 minutes to the call. A circular route, I think. Not much in the way of views today. It's drizzling a bit, so we think we might put the camera in the bag and put our shells on. We're climbing up the hill, we're about halfway up, we're still missing. It might have the advantage of hiding all the ski stuff on the other side, perhaps. So, but on the downside, we'll miss whatever view
there
is.
Said it's going to really hot on the top.
Yeah, we shall see.
And there's no shade.
You look well equipped there, aren't you?
There's no shade.
No shade, no. Get an early start if it's a hot day.
It did. Yeah. And we picked the wettest day.
It's drizzling, yeah. You never know, it might clear. We live in hope. This is what happens to a ski resort in summer. A blot on the landscape, and it's like a ghost. Everything's locked up. Picnic coat to be done. You just say it's out of here. This is clearing in patches. Look out there. Now we're making our way down to the Grust car park down there. Thank you.
We're still making our way down to Grust.
Le picnic.
The second half of our lunch.